For example, do you remember when we were dreaming along with Debussy? How after these vague opening bars, there came the first suggestion of a key, E major. And how that briefly suggested tonality instantly slipped away in a wash of sound that left us floating in distant waters, this dominant seventh chord. But now we can see why this, of all chords, was Debussy's choice. Because the root of that chord is B flat. And B flat is exactly a tritone away from E, which is where we thought we were. There's B flat, there's E, the tritone, the devil. And then in the ensuing bar of silence, we are left to float in blissful indecision between the two possibilities. B flat, E, silence. Do you begin to understand what I mean by Debussy's carrying out harmonic implications of the tritone? And equally important is the realization that this music is not just drowsily improvised, but carefully composed, intentionally designed to produce a specific ambiguous effect, which is a far cry from the conventional Hollywoodish idea of the moody composer improvising a vague dream in which anything can happen anywhere, Cornell Wilde or whoever it is. On the contrary, the Faun is a masterpiece of structure.